Yet another exciting episode of Pehen Code with me, Filoni Kanani. And today on the show with me, I have someone who is a Bollywood singer, an actress, a VJ, a TV presenter, such a high energy human being that she's a rock star performer. She's an amazing wife and one of the best mothers. Please welcome on the show, Khushbu Grewal. Hi, Khushbu.
You're very kind. With such kind words for me, my God. I'm a good wife. Did you speak to my husband about it?
Of course. I've experienced you both being together, right? I've met him.
Yes.
So,
yes,
yeah.
He gave you...
Exactly. I'm just so surprised. I thought you wouldn't remember, and I'll have to give context. And any I'll do that for, you know, the people who've tuned in to know. So we met at Seema's birthday. Seema is our common friend, right?
And she's my makeup artist, and Filoni's very good friend.
Yes, right. Perfect. So we met at her birthday. And it was late in the night, and I was returning home. And you guys saw me downstairs. I was waiting for a rickshaw. And you're like, we'll drop you home. I'm like, no, I live in Borivali. We are in Andheri. There is no way that you guys are going to drop me home. But you all insisted. And I was like, fair, fine. Let's do this. Drop me until the main road. And, you know, even then you're like, you know, reach home and drop me a message. And you all dropped me until the link road.
You did send me a message, and I was very impressed that you did.
Yeah, so I was like, wow, she is so amazing. And I remember seeing you in the party, and I was like, wow, she's a singer, and how am I going to talk to her? But you had absolutely no air about yourself, and which was what I loved about you. So that is so amazing. And there's one more incident that I want to share before we, you know, dive into this conversation. This is 2014. I was working in Coupon Dunya. And where Samir's company, Seema's husband.
No. Okay.
So I used to work in Coupon Dunya. And I had this colleague, and her younger sister would sing Pink Lips as Pink Clips. She's like, it's not Pink Lips, it's Pink Clips.
So cute.
I know, right? And then there I was in that party in front of someone who's actually sang Pink Lips.
So this is like, that's a big deal, trust me, it's not. I mean, you're doing such an amazing thing, getting amazing women on your show. And I love the name of your show, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think, Filoni, I get to hear that a lot. So, you know, my initial appearance to people comes across as a very arrogant person for some strange reason. And that was the reason that even when I was doing television back in the day, right, I used to get these really, you know, hoity-toity kind of roles, the antagonist of the show, or she's, you know, dragging the heroine down from the stairs, and, you know, doing mean things to them, and I used to be like, hi, why are you doing this? You know, so they're like, yeah, this is your acting, you know, you're going to be doing this, so, you know, pare from your personality, so that's when the real acting skills will come out. So I think, you know, the perception of a person and how the person really is are two very different things.
Exactly.
Is primarily made of perceptions and projections.
Right.
You know, very, very few people are really interested in knowing the person that you are, you know.
Right.
They're just trying to see what you're putting on Instagram, or what, you know, what is the projection of your image.
Exactly. You know,
that is a very big thing.
Exactly.
So, yeah, but I think, you know, at the end of the day, we're all the same. You know?
Right.
We're all the same.
Right.
You know. We're all movie lovers, food lovers, monsoon lovers. You know, we love to chill in our pajamas. Like, I'm wearing my pajamas now. This is just a facade. This is a facade. Iske niche nights. So, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I think there are a lot of judgment about people in media, which is good and bad. I mean, but I think there's so much more beyond a person's on-screen persona.
Right. Career.
So,
Wow, that's so true. So it was only when I was researching about you that I found out that you've done your MBA, and you're from Chandigarh, and you moved to Bombay after you got married, and how you moved to Bombay. So from doing MBA, you want a corporate job and all of that, and suddenly you're like, no, I want to go to Bombay and I want to be a singer. And what was that? Like, tell me about that. Like, how did this start?
I mean, when I was growing up, like any other girl, I would spend hours in front of the mirror wearing my, draping my mom's dupatta and wearing a sari and, you know, doing my catwalk and all that. And I was a drama queen, you know, right from school. I was on stage, you know, I don't even remember on what stage did I, at what age did I actually step on the stage the first time, because it happened so organically and it happened so early in my life. And I have to thank my school, you know, to give me that kind of a foundation and that stage that instilled that confidence in me from a very young age, that I became friends with the stage at a very early age. You know, by my fifth standard, I was choreographing acts without the help of my teachers. Wow. And, you know, I was like in charge, you know, and I'm talking about 20 years back when the exposure, media, YouTube was not so much. And I remember my first choreography was so hideous that I made all the girls stand in one queue, one behind the other. So only the first person was visible. Peeche koi dikhi nahi raha. So that was, you know, my brain and my choreography. But, you know, the fact that I was given opportunities, even though I hailed from a small town.
Right.
And again, people have this perception about small town girls and that, you know, they have limited exposure and unko kitna hi pata hoga types, you know. But I somehow feel that if you actually look around, there are so many small town people who made it so big in life, because somehow I think it's easier to make a mark for yourself in a small town when you're younger. And that gives you the confidence to go to a big city. Maybe if I would have grown up in a city like Bombay, I don't think I would have had the confidence to really go out there, because I would have been surrounded by such amazing, talented people that maybe I would have been intimidated by their talent. But because I'm in a small town, you know, there were lesser people, it was easy for me to be more visible and more seen and right. become popular. That instilled in me a confidence that I could do it. So, you know, I think this perception about small town people is pretty incorrect as far as my research goes.
Right.
Chopra comes from a small town called Bareilly. It's even smaller than Chandigarh.
Right.
And look at where she is. She's conquered Hollywood.
Exactly. You
know? Right. So, I think the opportunities that I got when I was growing up, and like every other girl, there was a time I wanted to come. Hostess, there was a time I wanted to become a teacher. Then post my 10th standard, when I had to choose my electives for 11th and 12th, is when I thought, yeah, let me take non-medical out and I want to pursue engineering and I want to become a corporate lawyer with an engineering background. I don't know what I was thinking. So, you know, so I went through these phases of so many different things, and I think all of us, when we were growing up, we were so confused. Definitely. You know, with the options that we had at that point.
Right.
And vocational studies was just opening up. And we had this phonetics and linguistics graduation course that started in our college. And I started doing that. And again, college served as a platform for me to take the stage. I became the cultural head and I was choreographing fashion shows. And so during this time, I realized that, you know, I have a relationship with the stage. That's a place where I really feel comfortable and I feel like I belong here. You know, the bigger the audience, the more I seem to be enjoying myself, you know. So that love affair kind of continued through school and college. And then I'd done my BA. And I said, abhi BA ke baad kya karein? Abhi kuch to dhang ka karna padega. So I said, chalo, MBA ke liye, let me just apply for CAT. And aur kuch nahi, to that time everybody was doing MBA. Jisko doctor, engineer nahi banna tha, wo MBA kar raha.
MBA
kar raha. So, chalo, let me also do MBA. So I gave my CAT results. I got an admission in which the institute that I had applied for. I was very happy. I was over the moon. From Chandigarh, I moved to Delhi. And I got to this really good institute and I did my MBA in marketing in HR. And by the time my MBA was getting over, it was time for me to start, because I was dating Bipin already by then for about 2.5-3 years.
Wow.
So as my wedding date was coming closer, I was also getting cold feet. I was like, oh my God, I'm not ready for this responsibility. And I don't, my God, I don't think I can do this. And, you know, Bipin used to keep telling me, chill, you don't have to do anything. You know, you just focus on your MBA right now, get over with this, and then we'll see aage kya karna. And I just happened to tell him one fine day, towards the end of my MBA. And I said, and our wedding was already fixed for Feb. March, I had my finals. Feb, ki hamari shaadi ki date pakki ho chuki thi. We okay. had booked the place. In October, I told Vipin, I said, meri na ek hi bas dream thi life mein, ki main Miss India mein part lu. So he's like, to le lo, Miss India mein part lene mein kya problem. I said, nahi, par abhi, main Feb mein Mrs. ho jaungi, to uske baad Miss India mein thodi part le sakti hoon. तो ही सेड तो मिसेस इंडिया में पार्ट ले लो हाउ डज इट मेक अ डिफरेंस मैं कहता तो देखो कितना एडवांटेज होगा बिकॉज़ यू आर सो यंग सो यू विल एनीवे विन यू नो यू माइट जस्ट विन मिसेस इंडिया आई सेड नहीं नहीं मुझे ऐसे ऐसे वाले यू नो आई डोंट वांट टू बी इन एन अनफेयर कंपटीशन आई वांट टू गो फॉर अ फेयर फाइट यू नो आई वांट टू गो फॉर मिस इंडिया सो ही सेड सो व्हाट डू यू वांट टू डू आई सेड आई डोंट नो आई एम जस्ट सेइंग इट वाज जस्ट आई मीन नाउ दैट वी आर गेटिंग मैरिड इन फेब आई डोंट थिंक आई विल एवर बी एबल टू डू दैट आई विल नेवर बी एबल टू पार्टिसिपेट इन मिस इंडिया सो ही सेड I don't want you to live with any regrets in life. Picked up his phone, he called up his mom and he said, listen, we'll have to postpone the wedding. And I'm sitting at, and I'm like, what the hell? Wow. I'll talk to you later, but now, don't plan any more on this. Just put the plan on hold.
Wow.
So, I'm flustered in Chandigarh, what happened? So, you know, mom called up, Masi, Mama, Nana, everyone told me that Vipin ka phone aaya. बच्चों में कुछ तो प्रॉब्लम हो गई है शादी इज बीन पुट ऑन होल्ड सो देन विपिन कॉल्ड अ मीटिंग इन हिज हाउस एंड ही सेड ओके सो खुशबू वांट्स टू पार्टिसिपेट इन मिस इंडिया एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई एम टेकिंग हर टू बॉम्बे टू गेट हर पोर्टफोलियो एंड एवरीथिंग डन एंड देन वील अप्लाई फॉर मिस इंडिया एंड देन डिपेंडिंग ऑन हाउ थिंग्स गो इफ शी लाइक विंस देन शी विल हैव अ 1 ईयर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट सो देन शी कांट मैरी फॉर 1 ईयर लाइक सी हाउ ऑप्टिमिस्टिक ही वाज बट ही सेड और अगर नहीं जीती तो वापस आएगी एक महीने में शादी कर लेंगे The family was like, you know what's wrong with you? What kind of husband are you? You want to send your wife for Miss India? Model banana kudi nu. So, you know, so he just heard it. He said, you know, I love you all and I respect you all, but this is a decision that's for Khushbu and me to decide. And the decision's been made, you know, and it was as simple as that. And he said, I've just called this meeting to let you all know that the wedding has been indefinitely postponed as of now. And we are going to Bombay. And everybody was okay, you know, what just happened. So we started working towards it and, you know, I got my portfolio made and everything. By chance that year, they increased their height bar from 5'6" to 5'7", so I couldn't qualify. Okay. So, yeah, I mean, they still did call me. I went to the prelims and, you know, I didn't make it to the finals. But in the process, when, you know, we came to Bombay, we got the portfolio and all done. A friend of mine saw that and she told Vipin that, yaar, teri fiance to badi hot hai. Tu wahan kya kar raha ho? Delhi, Delhi mein corporate job wo mat kar, tu Bombay aa ja. She is Simple Call. She's a
right,
actress.
I know Simple Call. Yes, that's yes. how so, you know her.
Yes. So she, her husband and my husband were partners in what, you know, the work that they were doing together.
Right.
So Vipin said, simple career that, you know, you have a lot of scope in Bombay. So let's just go to Bombay. And I was like, we can't just go to Bombay. I was getting a job with GlaxoSmithKline to work on Horlicks.
Wow.
And I said, I'm getting a fantastic job and I'm getting 45,000 rupees,
that's,
you know, for that job.
Okay, yeah. It's a lot of money.
I'm a junior brand manager. I wasn't even going as an intern. They were hiring me straight as a junior brand manager. So I was like, dude, I can't leave this. So, you know, Vipin is somebody, Filoni, I think, he has been the reason I've been able to do, you know, whatever little I've been able to do in life, because he does not like to be in his comfort zone. And I'm somebody who likes to be in my comfort zone. He's somebody who likes to take, you know, risks and, you know, be adventurous and, you know, okay, we have to do this. It's one life and, you know, we can't live with any regrets. So, 7th of May, we got married. 9th of May, we were in Bombay. We just packed our bags. We didn't know anybody. We just landed here. We had no idea how we were going to survive. We had no idea what we were going to do. But we just came here with dreams in our eyes and we knew that we could work hard and make this happen. And so, that was it. Yeah, it was a wish in my mind, which he made true for me.
Right. You know,
it was a dream that I dreamt of, but I never thought that I'm going to pursue it. I never thought I had the courage to come to a city, a big city like this and, you know, struggle. And, you know, we'd heard stories and everything. I didn't have it in me to do that all by myself. It was only because of him, the courage he gave me, and the fact that he stood by me and he said, don't worry, what worst will happen? You'll fail. You won't make it. You are a qualified, educated person. We go back to Delhi, we pick up jobs and life goes back to where it was. You know, we pick up from where we left. What is it that we have to lose? What can we lose at this point?
Right.
And I said, okay, you know, the man has a point. So, yeah, and that was that. Yeah, and then we just came.
Awesome. To Bombay. And then you started working with B4U, and that's when you became a VJ. Is that?
So,
I'm trying to understand then, when did Coke Me Pop Stars happen?
That was much earlier. That was much earlier when I had no plans of coming to Bombay.
Okay.
I was, you know, a aimless youngster in Chandigarh who read this ad, Channel V is coming. And I didn't even read the full ad. I just saw Channel V is coming, auditions ho rahe, bas itna padha, mujhe laga VJ ke liye. Maine kaha, aur ye Bombay to main padhi kar leti hu, VJ ban jate padha. So I maine form fill kar diya, aur main pahunch gayi. It was a free one. So some 2000 people had come. So when I went there, and I was standing in the queue, and I saw people like singing songs, and I was like, what's happening here? So they said, music competition. I said, oh, acha, it's a music competition. So I said, meri jagah rakhna, and I quickly went to the PCO, and I called my mother. I said, mama, ye to music competition hai yahan pe, jiske liye main aayi hu, VJ banni hai. So my mother's like, ga de gaana koi. So I said,
I love you.
So मैंने कहा पंजाबी गा तुम शिदे खा माँ ही आवेगा गाते तू बड़ा अच्छा गाती है मैंने कहा अच्छा चलो ठीक है मैं सिंग दैट ओके I hung up I went back so my friends came to meet me okay because it was a long waiting like we were there since morning या दो के बज चुके थे अभी तक मैं क्यू में थी so my friends came and they're like they're looking at the queue and they're like तेरे को लग रहा है कि इतने सारे लोगों में से तू सिलेक्ट होने वाली है तो I'm like क्यों नहीं हो सकती मैं सिलेक्ट so they're like चलते हैं कहीं लंच वंच करते हैं मम्मी को घर जाके बोलना मम्मा सिलेक्ट ही नहीं हुई और यू नो वी विल हैव अ गुड टाइम एंड वी विल गो होम सो आई वाज लाइक नो इफ यू ऑल वांट टू स्टे विद मी यू स्टे विद मी इफ यू ऑल वांट टू गो यू गो आई एम नॉट गोइंग आई एम जस्ट स्टेइंग इन द क्यू एंड आई एम गिविंग माय एंड आई एम सो ग्लैड आई डिड बिकॉज यू नो सो मेनी टाइम्स व्हेन वी रीच अ प्लेस इन लाइफ वेयर वी फील लाइक वी आर अमंगस्ट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल हु आर कंपीटिंग फॉर दैट स्पॉट Just that can overwhelm us. And you know, we can lose hope at that point. And we can say, oh my God, really, I'm not better than all these people.
All of these guys.
They all have the skill set. I mean, I had people next to me who were pursuing their graduation in music and who was like proper studying music, right? And I was like, you know, like they're amazing, but I still want to try, you know? Like I was in awe of people singing around me. And I had zero background in music. And I said, But I know I sing well and I have always, you know, gone up on the stage and sung without any training. I want to try. I want to see hota kya. So I went, I gave my first round and voila, I got selected for the next round. And I was like, okay, this seems good. So we moved to the top 50 in Chandigarh. Yes. So then we were called the next day. So then the next day again I went and then I made it to the top 25 and then I made it to the top 10 in Chandigarh and then they said now you all go home you're going to get a call some of you might be called to Bombay or might not be depending on how the pan India competition looks like
right
so then eventually after a couple of days we got a call and I got picked up from Chandigarh I was one of the two people from Chandigarh to make it for and I was probably the only one who didn't have a background in music in the entire team of pop stars yes my sweetheart yes come So, you know, so many times we limit ourselves with our own mind. You know, we think that, oh God, I don't know this and I don't know that. And I do that. I mean, I beat myself till today for so many things. And I say, oh my God, how will I ever do this? So, yeah, you know, I think we beat ourselves up. Sometimes we're a little harsh on ourselves and we undermine our own talent,
right.
skill. And, you know, I think Filoni, somewhere God has his own way of balancing out things in your life, if there will be things, if there will be, you know, a little less of talent that he's given you, maybe he'll give you a little bit of more confidence, you know, a little bit of more stage presence. So I think the thing that pulled me off at that point and at that stage when I was so young was the fact that I was uninhibited. We become inhibited as we grow older.
Right.
You know, the younger we are, we just go anywhere and do anything and we think we can conquer the world.
Yeah.
We have nothing to lose. We have nothing on stake. We are not worried about what people are going to think of us. We are not worried about what anybody is going to say or what, am I looking like a fool doing this, you know?
Right.
So I think most of the things that we accomplish in life are, if they are at a much younger age, are primarily because of the fact that we are not afraid of the consequences.
Right.
We're not afraid of failure. You know, right. we have no image to save.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I know.
So yeah, so I was exactly at that stage in my life where it didn't matter to me. I mean, the worst would have been that I wouldn't have been selected. You know, वैसे भी अभी क्या कर रही हूँ? बिल्ली घूम रही हूँ चंडीगढ़ चलो ठीक है. You know, it was like that.
Wow.
Yes. Yes. You go. This is what happens in your TV. Bhago. So yeah, you know, I think. So it was never planned, Filoni. You know, it, like I said, I called my mom. Hey, it's a singing competition. You know, it was like that.
Yeah.
But because I was, you know, since the time I was little, I was just fond of entertaining people. And I, you know, every time a teacher would be absent and there would be a substitute teacher. Okay, who's going to come here and entertain the class? And my hand, I won't come. I'll do something. I'll sing dance. I'll be a joke. I'll do something, you know.
Wow.
Just give me a chance to entertain. So, yeah, I think that that kind of really lay the foundation for this entire journey, which I never thought.
So, Khushbu, were you the same Khushbu when you moved to Bombay, when you took up the B for you, like after you got married and you took up that, you know, VJ job and you did it for like 7 years, good 7 years, right? And so, were you still that same person who was like, you know what, if, even if I fail, kya ho gaya? Theek hai. Or were you this?
Okay. You know, we figured out within a couple of weeks that this is going to be tough. This is not as easy as mere paas MBA ki degree hai, mujhe job de do, achha, itne ki job.
Exactly.
It's not as easy
right.
as that, right?
It's
you need contacts. I think that is one of the biggest things that you need when you're in a city like this.
Right.
Through Simple, I joined a gym. And she said, Jim, aja, aur yaha, and she's also a big chatterbox. Aja, yaha, bada aata hai, aap bade log milenge, bade friends banenge, to aja, hum saath mein workout karenge, aisa. Chalo, theek hai, workout karne aa jaati hu main. So I started going to the gym. And this guy who comes to the gym, who's Simple's friend, he spots me yapping away to glory. And he's saying, ye, treadmill pe iske paon kam chal rahe, iska muh zyada chal raha hai, you know. So he comes to me, he's like, would you be interested in becoming a VJ? And I was like,
wow.
Possible? So he's like, sure, can. I mean, you're a chatterbox. You talk so much. That's the kind of person you need. I was like, okay. What do I have to do?
Wow.
And I'm looking at like top to bottom, thinking that he must be some sleaze ball. Who, you know, then will take a number. I'd just come to Bombay and I'd heard these stories. And
yeah.
Ye number lega. Ab fir mere ko message.
Exactly what I was thinking.
So I said, so what do I have to do? Like what? He's like, you give me your number. I said, see, you have your number. You give me your number and I will get in touch with you. Okay, you got a number. Okay. So we exchange the numbers and then next thing, messages me that, listen, I'm shooting on next Tuesday, whatever. Come, we'll take your audition. I was like, okay. So I got dressed and everything and I went and I told Bipin, I said, I'm going to call you if there's anything, you know. He's like, don't worry. It's Simple's friend. It's Salil, you know. So don't worry.
Ah. Is that Salil Acharya?
That's right.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So, Kasaka and Mumbai.
Yeah. I know.
Okay. So I went and then he was sitting in front of the camera and he's, you know, he was recording his own episode. And he was going on and on talking to the camera. I don't think I mean, give me a human at least. I'll talk to a human.
Yeah, it's really hard.
I was like, dude, I don't think I can do that. So he finished like some 3-4 episodes back to back and then he said, so you saw what I did. And he's like, got a lot of energy. And he said, you saw what I did. So it's just very simple. Just go sit there, just talk about whatever movie, whatever. I'm looking at him and he's like, I have to talk to the camera. He's like, yeah, just go say whatever you want. I was like, okay. I don't know. I'll try. Okay. So he's like, yeah, go. Just chill. Just talk about which was your last movie you saw. Kabhi Khushi Kabhi. Okay, go. Talk about Kabhi Khushi Kabhi. Just say something. So I went and I just blabbered something, and then they gave me some format that he bol do. So I did all of that. I came back home. He said, "We'll let you know." I said, "Okay." Nothing happened. No coffee, nothing. So I was like, "Okay, that was easy." So I came home, and then I didn't hear from them for 3 months. Koi kuch nahi. October, I met them. So May, I moved to Bombay. October, I met Salil. I gave the audition. Then, I don't hear from them for 3 months. I was like, chalo. I knew they were auditioning, and they had auditioned a lot of girls, because the cameraman said ke har roz itne audition hote hain. And I was like, oh my God, okay. Oh. So I said, obviously somebody must have been selected.
Huh.
February, I get a call, and I'm like, then this person says, hello, Dharminder ke bungalow paun sakti hain abhi fada fad se. I'm like, sorry. Nahi, wo actually, hume urgently abhi shoot karna hai, hum aapka contract baad mein sign karte rahenge, aap VJ ki tarah hire hogi, lekin aaj ek urgent shoot aaya, aap bas VJ nahi, aap fada fad se Dharminder ke bungalow paun jaiye. आपको हमारा मेकअप आर्टिस्ट मिलेगा गुरु, एंड वो यहाँ पे आपका मेकअप पिकअप करके. So I immediately started doing my research on honeymoon travels and Abhay Deol, and you know, to be like all well prepared and everything. And I went there, I gave my, you know, I took my first interview as a VJ, and I was so nervous. And I told him, I said, dude, I'm like so nervous. This is my first interview. He's like, oh, don't worry, it's okay, it's gonna be fine, we're just gonna chit chat. I was like, okay, fine. And it went on great. Like, you know, it was supposed to be a 20-minute episode, but it went on for like 45, 50 minutes. And, you know, the team was very happy. They're like, you were such a natural. I was like, okay, fine. So the next thing I know, I signed, and then I
interviewed like, Amitabh Bachchan.
I have. Gosh, that was amazing. And you know, I wasn't a fan of Bachchan Saab before I met him. When I came to Bombay, I realized that people are very serious about the film business. Okay, like they say Bachchan Saab, and you know, they're very filmy. You know, Khan Saab, but you know, they talk like that. I came from Chandigarh. It's Amitabh Bachchan.
Right.
I was like, why are people so serious about Bachchan Saab ki film dekhi and Bachchan Saab ki? You know, they talk about these filmy
characters. It's like, a religion.
Yeah, it is. And I was like, okay, I mean, theek hai, honge Bachchan Saab, honge jo bhi hai, but theek hai, but kya? You know, I was like that.
Right.
What's the big deal? Why are people so crazy about Bachchan Saab? I had and I also grew up in the era where I had only seen films from 90s and beyond. So I hadn't seen a lot of those. Sholay and all I hadn't seen.
Huh.
Okay. So when Bachchan Saab actually came on set and we interviewed him, I remember taking his hand and I just didn't let go. And I was like, oh my God, I said, now I know why the world is crazy about you.
Right.
You
know, the aura is so strong, right?
It's just, oh my God. It's just such an amazing personality.
Right.
You know, and the way he conducts himself, his demeanor, his humility, his punctuality, his professionalism. Wow. Each and everything, it's impeccable. You know, and you're like, my God, this is how legends are. You know, when you meet somebody and you're like, wow. So yeah, that was the time when I was absolutely awestruck, and so that was amazing. It's awesome. Been amazing.
So this was your VJing journey. So then, how did your Bollywood happen? How did Bollywood happen to you?
So when I was VJing, somebody spotted me from Vishesh Films. Somebody spotted me, you know, VJing, and they called up Salil and they said that, listen, you're co-VJ, you know. Can she talk in Hindi? Because BFU was an English channel. He said, can she like talk? He's like, dude, she's a Panju. Like, she's hardcore Hindi, but like, she's a proper Panju. He's like, okay, because, you know, we don't want that typical tutti-futti VJ English, Hindi. You know, we see a lot of these MTV VJs, they can't speak proper Hindi. We want proper Hindi. So, you know, like, Bhatt Saab is very particular about the Hindi. So, Salil was like, arey, bindas, you know, meet her and audition her and everything. So, I remember I was in the middle of some AV shoot. It was 11 o'clock in the night. I get a call. Hi, I'm so and so. It was Mohit Suri's assistant.
Okay.
And he said, Vishal Mhatkar. And he said, I'm calling you from Mahesh Bhatt's office, Vishesh Films, and I got your number from Salil, and we'd like to meet you. And it's 11 p.m. I looked at the time and I was like, that's shady business. This is shady business.
Okay. Again.
I was like, dude. So, you know, I had these two girls with me who were on set. And I was like, you know, I'm going to pack up late. It's going to be really, it's going to be like one. No worries. We'll wait for you. I was like, oh my God, you know, we could have just said, come tomorrow. See your urgency
coming. Exactly. This is happening now. Yes.
टीवी में यही दिखाते हैं कि लड़कियां ऐसे रात को जाती हैं प्रोडक्शन हाउस में और फिर ऐसे नामी ग्रामी प्रोडक्शन हाउसेस के ही पर्दे के पीछे क्या हो रहा होता है ओके क्या वो करूं अब मैं सो आई टोल्ड दीस टू गर्ल्स वर विद मी फ्रॉम द प्रोडक्शन कंपनी दैट आई वाज शूटिंग फॉर एंड आई सेड यू नो गर्ल्स कैन यू कम विद मी बिकॉज़ आई हैव टू गो एंड स्टॉप समवेयर ऑन द वे फॉर एन ऑडिशन एंड आई एम नॉट कंफर्टेबल गोइंग अलोन सो दे आर लाइक या कम कम वी गो सो यू नो द थ्री ऑफ अस वेंट एंड आई यू नो आई टोल्ड देम आई सेड यू ऑल स्टे इन द कार If you don't hear from me in 15 minutes, you just barge in. You just come. So they're like, listen, nobody will rape you, first of all. You know, if something happens, it will be with your consent or it won't happen. But nobody will rape you. Okay. So I was like, okay, but you know, I don't know. I mean, this is like the first for me, you know, coming to a big production house. And I was like, I don't know, Just you just be on standby. So they're like, we're on standby. So I went in, there was this really sweet guy and he's like, sorry, this is a script and if you could just, you know, I'll give you 15 minutes to read the script and then let me know when you're ready, I'll come and take your audition. I said, oh, okay, theek hai. So I quickly messaged the girl and said, sweet guy, all okay, don't worry, I'm fine. So I auditioned, the next morning I got a call that, you know, Mohit's liked your audition and we'll start shooting and we'll have to go to Cape Town and stuff. So yeah, you know, so they start. So, you know, one film happened and then for you only, and you know, I got into Punjabi films and then from one film, you know, you make contacts and you get into another film and stuff. So I've been honestly lucky that because I know for a fact that it's not hard, it's not easy to get work at all.
Right.
It's not easy, you know, to even get into camps or, you know, get into production houses that have their own set of people that they work with.
Right.
Even if it's for a small role. And to do it with my own limitations, personal limitations that, you know, I knew that there was certain the value system that I had to work with.
Right.
I feel that I'm very, very blessed that keeping that value system intact, I could do whatever little work that I've done with my dignity and my head held high. And right. I think that is of utmost importance to me, you know, that... whatever it is that I've done it purely on my merit, and that is most precious to me, you know.
Right.
So, and so that's how Bollywood happened, that's how Punjabi films happened. So, you know, one thing led to the other, and you know, just went on like that. And then TV happened, and then I started doing television. I did television for a long time, like I did fiction shows and stuff. And I was playing the vamp in a couple of shows, and again, that was an exciting journey. And then music happened, so yeah.
Right. So let's address the elephant in the room. How did Pink Clips happen?
So I had no intentions of getting into music as a professional. I used to sing, and even when I was DJing, and I used to sing a lot on my show. And in BFU also, everybody knew, my audiences knew that ye aayi hai to ye gaegi. In fact, BFU had so many cases on them because I used to sing songs that they didn't have rights for. So they used to, you know, I used to get, अरे तुम्हारे पास एक और केस हो गया, एक और म्यूजिक कंपनी ने केस, तो क्यों गाने गाती रहती हो शो में? I think, dude, that's me, you know, I can't stop doing that. So I knew that, you know, like even when I used to go on stage and I used to anchor shows, I used to sing a lot. Like I used to just pick up people, I used to sing and make them dance. And so I was doing a show with Mika, and he told me that aap jaake aaj show open karo, gana gao. And I was like,
wow.
Are you serious? Like, arey karo. So I did that, you know, I sang. We were doing a show in Chandigarh. He's like, arey thoda share hai yaar, jao Punjabi gaane gao. So I went and sang a couple of songs and the reaction was amazing. Then I did a show with the Meek brothers and they were sitting in the like backstage and I went out there and I was singing and I was, you know, and they're like, dude, you're wasting your talent. What the hell are you doing? Like, great, you're a great anchor and everything, but you're a fab singer and you have the ability to engage. Why are you not pursuing? You've been doing this and you've not sung. Like, what are you doing with your life? So, and they were really close friends. So, they really took my, you know, case on that, that you are a waste. You have wasted your 10 years. And, you know, you, what have you done? And I was like, oh God, are you serious? I'm not even a trained singer. And they're like, it doesn't matter. You can train now. You know, it's never too late to learn something. So, they pushed me to, you know, kind of start looking at music. And then one day, I was in my house. And my house is situated right behind their studio. And at about 1 o'clock in the morning, I get a call. Khushi, you're free. I was like, kya ho gaya? Padavat se aaja, gana gana. I was like, acha, theek hai. So, I mean, I used to go to their studio so often that this time no bad thoughts came to my mind. I was like, gana hi gana hoga. So, I immediately went and I was like, abhi is time kya ho gaya? Kehte hai, yaar, wo brief aaya hua. And, you know, we can't call any other singer at 1 o'clock. So, I knew ki aap to peeche hi rehte ho. So, Phadavat se scratch, it's a dummy. We'll make some other singer sing it tomorrow. But as of now, we have to send it to Bhushanji right now. So, waiting. So, aap phat se kuch bhi do line ga ke, you go. I was like, okay, that. Man, unne bola, maine ga diya, I left. In a couple of days, I get a call. Mithai ka dabba leke a jao, aapka pehla playback aa raha hai. Like,
what?
Yeah, they're like, हाँ आपकी आवाज पसंद आ गई डायरेक्टर को और भूषण जी ने भी ओके कर दिया एंड आप ही की आवाज लग रही है सनी पे. I was like, what? And just then Baby Doll had become like a raging hit.
Right.
And then Sunny Leone and the Meet Brothers. And I was like, oh my God, wow. That, you know, when that happened is when I said, okay, no, now I need to stop saying yes to TV offers. And I was just in the middle of negotiations for a very big mythological show as the antagonist.
Okay.
And they in fact came to the studio to have a meeting with me and they tried to convince Manmeet also that the Meet Brothers that, you know, let her do this show. It's a big show and it was going to be a big show on a big channel. And they said, no, you know, she has another career waiting for her. That's, she has to be there.
Wow.
You know, so I had to literally shut, you know, my other doors to kind of concentrate on music because I said, now that my song is coming in a film, now that the title of playback singer is coming next to my name, I can't be doing, you know, other things.
Yes.
Concentrate on music.
Wow.
So that's when I actually took my singing ability seriously, when somebody else tried to put a buck on it and I said, okay, you know, if somebody is willing to put my voice on a heroine and in a song, then there must be something which I'm not being able to see.
Right.
But if the experts are seeing it, then I have to sometimes just trust their judgment, right?
Right, right.
So that kind of gave me the confidence and I took the plunge. Yeah.
Wow, you literally have answered a question that I had in mind. That what's this rapport that you have with Meet Brothers? Because I always see you, you know, on all the shows with them and you're also largely working with them. And you know, you can see that rapport is real, that friendship is real, Touchwood. So that...
You know, even Baby Doll and all happened, we've been family friends for a very long time.
Okay.
So we used to hang out together, party together. They were also at that point waiting for that one big break in their life that's going to change their life. So, you know, I was doing my own thing, they were doing their own thing. But, you know, we were all struggling together, you know, in the sense, you know, we talk about our work issues, we would talk about the struggles that we're going through and everything. And before Baby Doll came, we decided that we're going to make a band. So they said, you know, like we sing a lot of female songs in our show. Like, you know, even if we are doing a Kajrare or we are doing a Billo Rani, you know, as boys, it doesn't look good that we are singing Billo Rani, you know.
No.
So we do a lot of stage shows. Why don't you join us as a third member and we make a band?
Awesome.
And you do the female parts and we do the male parts. And I was like, yeah, that sounds cool. And I was very happy that, you know, I was going to be getting into the show scene. And if I would have got that kind of experience by being with them in their shows, I would just get a sense of what a show looks like and how you've got to really conduct yourself. So I looked at it like a learning step for me to get into the industry. I said, okay, that sounds great. So we started doing these shows together and then Baby Doll happened. And that's obviously what changed their life, right? Because when Baby Doll became a hit, they started doing way more shows than they were doing earlier and they became way more popular. They started doing TV appearances. But by then, because our band was already formed, you know, much before that, so we had that like an unsaid pact that, you know, we're going to be together. Like, you know, right. we did this together. We've come so far together. So we're kind of going to stick together. It was more like, you know, more than a professional, it was a personal pact that we had with each other, that right. we were all helping each other grow and we were kind of together and everything. So, so we continued and we kind of formalized that entire thing. And that's how I continue to lead till today.
Right. And do you realize that you've not sung even a single line for us yet?
You are
generally so high energy. And, you know, I've seen your live sessions and you're on your own, but it feels like it's a concert. And you've not sung on my show. That cannot happen. Your choice.
मुझे आधी रात को सताने लगे मुझे अपने साथ तड़पाने लगे तू आ जा पास से बुलाने लगे तुझे छूना चाहे मेरे ये मेरे पिंक लिप्स पिंक लिप्स पिंक लिप्स पिंक लिप्स पिंक लिप्स पिंक लिप्स पल पल तुझको करते मिस पिंक लिप्स pink lips, pink lips, pink lips. I know you want my baby lips.
Awesome. Khushbu, I have like last one or two questions for you. I want to go back to the beginning of our conversation for this one. I can very confidently say that Bipin has been a very important, person in your life. And not just because he's your partner, but also because he pushed you to, you know, chase your dreams, right? So you found that out about him eventually. But what was it that made you think that, you know, this is the guy that I want to be with?
So the place where I grew up, the city where I grew up, and the age when I met him, I was 18. I was still not 18, I think, or I was 17. No, I was 18. I was 18 when I met him. And I was surrounded by a very different set of boys who would have like this Dimchak music in their car, loud music and, you know, big phones and Mawa ka paisa and, you know, the typical North Indian kind of boys. And they're like so entertaining and they're so fun to be with. But I used to be like, you know, if I have to marry someone, I need somebody who's not throwing his parents' money. You know, I want somebody who's self-made. I want to be with somebody who has a mind of his own, who's, you know, independent, who's, who has some things he stands for in life, you
know?
And then I came across Bipin. He was my best friend's boss. And when I met him, I interacted with him. At a very early age, though he was staying in Chandigarh, he was not living with his family. He was independently staying in a rented accommodation with a second-hand car, which he had bought with his own money.
Right.
And though he was broke, he had zero money in his bank. But whatever he had was his own.
Right.
You know, that he was proud of. That, you know, don't... I remember when we were getting a little serious and he said, he made a statement to me. He said, "Mere maa baap ka ghar mat dekhna. मेरे माँ बाप की गाड़ी मत देखना उनकी घड़ियां मत देखना वो मेरी नहीं मेरा यही है वो उनका है ये मेरा है सो इफ यू आर मेकिंग अ डिसीजन टू मैरी मी रिमेंबर दैट आई कम टू यू विद अ जीरो बैंक अकाउंट आई हैव अर्नड सिंस आई वाज अ वेरी यंग गाय एंड आई हैव ब्लोन एंड आई हैव एंजॉयड माय लाइफ एंड आई हैव लिव्ड ईच डे एंड दिस इज द पर्सन आई एम एंड आई डोंट कैरी एनीथिंग फ्रॉम देम यू नो आई डोंट डिपेंड ऑन देयर लेगेसी एंड आई डोंट यू नो डिपेंड ऑन व्हाट they have if they you know if tomorrow they give me something by choice it's something else but I don't want you to think ki acha iski to backing hai ya you know iske parents set hai unka acha bada ghar hai ye soch ke nahi shaadi kar you know he's like this is me and that is them
wow
and I was like okay. And that approach kind of was really attractive to me because I've seen my mother and father really slog it out and you know really work hard to make what they actually had at that point
right
and I understood the value of starting from the beginning and doing everything on your own and right. I used to always feel that I want to have such stories to tell my children when they grow up, wow. you know, that, you know, your mama and papa, we stayed in a small wow. house in Bombay. You know, and you know, my mother used to tell me, beta, film nahi chal rahi hai koi.
I love that.
So when I met him and I saw these things about him, and you know, when he talks, and he's extremely witty, that was one trait of his that really, really took me. By surprise, because he comes with a very stern, straight face, a man of few words. And then when he starts talking, you're like rolling on the floor because he's like really funny.
Right.
And, you know, men who make you laugh, I think are meant for keeps. So I was like, dude, this guy can make me laugh. Okay, so that's funny. And you know, that there was just something about him, like even when we were dating, I remember... He was the one who really got after me, and he said, I was getting a job after my graduation, and I was, you know, somebody who had worked with on a part-time basis was offering me like a partnership in a firm, and you know, and I was like, dude, after graduation, I'm becoming a partner of a company and I'm getting like 15,000 rupees. And he's like, relax, relax.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, you can't get, you know, swayed by these things. You have to do your post-graduation. Wow. You have to do your MBA and you have to complete your education. And अभी जो आपको लग रहा है एक्साइटिंग 15,000 बहुत बड़ी चीज है इट्स लाइक दिस बी चेंज फॉर यू आफ्टर योर अ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट बिकॉज़ यू विल गेट वे मोर देन दैट सो यू नो ही रियली वाज समबडी हु पुश्ड मी टू डू द राइट थिंग्स इन लाइफ मेक द राइट चॉइसेस इन लाइफ एंड ही मेड मी थिंक फॉर माय सेल्फ यू नो दैट वाज अगेन समथिंग व्हिच वाज अमेजिंग लाइक ही रियली पुश्ड मी टू टेक माय ओन डिसीजंस And even my parents were like that. I was out up in a, with a very independent decision-making ability. And from a very, very young age, I started going out and shopping for myself. I started doing stage shows at a very early age. And I used to go on my own and, you know, travel on my own. And so, you know, I think that style of parenting kind of met that style of romance in mm-hmm. my life. That, you know, I found the same kind of a life partner right. who believed in my thought process and value system of giving, control to the other person and, you know, empowering them and having faith in them and giving them the right to make decisions. That, I think I could relate to him so much more given the background that I was coming from. And I said, okay, you know, and I had seen so many people around me, so many relationships, like, you know, girlfriends, boyfriends at that point where they're suspicious and they're checking their phones and, you know, they're constantly bickering and fighting. I was like, my God, I don't want to be with somebody who can't trust. Like, trust is so essential. And then there was Bipin, who was like so trusting that I remember when I came to Bombay and I used to be like hanging out with my guy friends and my colleagues and, you know, Salil, for example, or any other guy friend who I'm shooting with, and we would just end up going out for dinner after work or whatever. And I used to call him, you don't love me, you don't feel jealous. Like, you have no problem. I'm hanging out with this guy at 1 in the night. He's like, they're your friends, it's okay. You should have a good time. You worked all day, you slogged, you deserve to go get yourself a drink. And, you know, I was like, my God, how are you like this? You know, it used to amaze me. It used to amaze me. So I've learned a lot from him because I was so young and we have a 7-year age gap. So he was 25 when I was 18.
Wow.
So, you know, so I've learned so much from him. I've evolved so much thanks to him, with him. Wow. So it's amazing. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay. So Khushbu, my final question would be, what is that one piece of advice that you would want to give to the Khushbu who was just very new to Bombay?
I think the one piece of advice, when I look back now and... I would say, get out of your comfort zone. You know, I stuck to Be For You for about 7 years because I got so comfortable doing what I was doing that I stopped really struggling to find more facets of my personality.
Right.
You know, kind of, I got stuck in one place for a long time and I think that stalled my growth in other departments, you know, right. because I was like, oh, I'm doing so great as a VJ and, you know, you think, wow, so you're sorted. But, you know, I think... Today is the time for those people who are multitasking and can do, you know, various things. And it's amazing that people don't judge you anymore. You know, that whole statement of jack of all trades and master of none, it's become passé now.
Right.
now is the time for those people who can be an entrepreneur at the same time, philanthropist at the same time, be a, you know, professional at the same time, do honorary work in the school at the same time. And
it's the need of the hour to don different hats.
Yes. So, you know, I think if I had to go back and give an advice to Khushbu, I would say explore yourself more and trust your instincts and step out of your comfort zone.
Awesome. Thank you so very much. I've loved and enjoyed every story that you've shared here because it's been so honest and so from the heart. And what I loved absolutely and I'm surprised to discover about you is that you're so innocent. Like from the very first minute you started talking, like, please don't lose this about you. I love this.
So sweet. Thank you, Filoni. Thank you so much.
Thank you for doing this.
All the best with your amazing podcast that you can keep getting all the amazing guests that you want on your show. And bless you.
Thank you. Means a lot. Thank you.
See you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Every time we say goodbye, they all see that it's a lie. 'Cause we always give it one last try. Yeah, you've watched me break a thousand times. Now I'm all alone, 'cause you never show. You say you will, but then you